Elon Musk is known to always push the boundaries in all that he does. His car manufacturing company, Tesla, is poised to deliver at least 1.5 million electric vehicles this year. And despite already building Starship, the most powerful rocket in the universe, Musk aerospace startup SpaceX is currently developing a next-generation version of this spacecraft that will drive the billionaire's ambition to colonize Mars. But how powerful is this rocket? What will NASA gain from its development? Join us in today's video as we explore the features of the incoming Starship 2.0. SpaceX is one of Elon Musk's most thriving innovative businesses. Since its inception in March 2002, the company has gone on to win several contracts from NASA worth billions of dollars. However, the aerospace company also contributes a great deal to the American economy as well, and it's not just in taxes. On July 21, 2011, NASA brought its space shuttle program to a close after spending $200 billion, traveling 135 flights, and suffering two deadly accidents. For the next 9 years, American astronauts will have no option but to travel to space in Russian Soyuz rockets. Elon Musk's SpaceX broke this weird cycle in August 2020 when the Dragon spacecraft launched two NASA astronauts, Bob Behnken and Doug Hurley, to space. And since then, the relationship between both parties has continued to grow. SpaceX is one of NASA's main contractors, and in return, the aerospace company has earned enough funds to stay in business and recognition to attract private clients. Currently, the company has a number of spacecrafts, including the Dragon X, Falcon 9, and the Starship, which is viewed as the spacecraft that could well launch humanity into our future home. It's no secret that Elon Musk wants to colonize space. The tech billionaire has been on it for a while, and he has even set a time frame of 2050 to achieve this goal. NASA too is keen to send humanity to the moon again after our cameo appearance back in 1969. And that's where the Starship 2.0 rocket comes in. Creating a civilization on a planet that's 62.07 million kilometers away would require a lot in terms of logistics and planning. To begin with, the Earth-Mars launch window, the best energy-efficient orbit to travel to the red planet, happens once every 26 months. Launching the spacecraft at any other period could lead to a disastrous situation. For instance, the spaceship could arrive in the planet's orbit where the planet is not there. Imagine the type of dilemma that would cause. Meanwhile, Elon Musk reckons that we'll need to relocate 1 million humans to Mars to kickstart the colonization process. Also, the billionaire reckons that about 100 megatons of freight must be moved from Earth to the red planet to put structures in place, creating a sustainable environment for humans and also to ensure our continued existence on the planet. The billionaire didn't say exactly what he will be looking to transport there. But we imagine it will include equipment to generate oxygen and electricity, amongst other important things like food and telecommunication systems. Based on the specifications of the current Starship, Musk believes that 1,000 trips will be needed to get those things. But even that is a complicated process, because as of today, there's no spacecraft that can transport humans or freight to Mars. And that's one of the reasons why Musk is developing the Starship rocket. Another motivation behind the Starship project would be Musk's relationship with NASA. As one of its biggest and most trusted contractors, NASA relies on SpaceX a lot, especially in terms of transporting humans and cargo to space. And there's a strong belief that when NASA's Artemis astronauts eventually land on the moon in 2025, it will be in a Starship rocket. The Pentagon is also eyeing the possibility of adopting this spacecraft to transport military equipment and personnel. Private individuals and entities are also in the queue, hoping to benefit from the offerings of the Starship rocket, which is expected to reduce the cost of space transportation significantly. And just like every other thing that Elon Musk is involved in, when this rocket is finally ready to sail, it will be the benchmark of all spacecraft. That's crystal clear, even by assessing its specifications. When attached to its booster, the Starship Super Heavy rocket measures nearly 400 feet in height. That's more than 30 metres taller than the Saturn V rocket that transported humans to the moon, and almost 100 feet taller than the famous Statue of Liberty, ultimately cementing its position as the tallest spacecraft in the world. Once this rocket escapes into orbit, its super heavy booster, which measures 230 feet, will separate and return to the launch pad, where it will be caught by mechanical arms, which Elon Musk describes as chopsticks. Meanwhile, the Starship itself will continue its journey into deep space. The Starship 2.0 will be even more gigantic, about 8 times bigger than the current model, measuring the same height as the famed Woolworths building in New York. Despite the fact that it is yet to travel on its first official mission, the Starship has seen a number of upgrades already. One of them is the Raptor engine, which is currently being redesigned to become more efficient, and Musk is directly overseeing that process. It will no longer be called Raptor as well. According to reports, SpaceX plans to fit more of these engines into the Starship and the Super Heavy booster, increasing the maximum payload from 100 tons to 150 tons. Unlike other aerospace companies, SpaceX employs an unconventional approach to building its rockets. Instead of testing each component one after the other, the company fits them together and tests the whole prototype itself. This method allows it to develop rockets at a faster rate, but of course it has led to accidents that cost them hundreds of millions of dollars on a number of occasions. But then, SpaceX has always soaked in the experience and learned from the mistakes to emerge stronger from the situation. Long before Elon Musk announced the Starship 2.0 project, most people, including NASA, were sold on the idea of the Starship rocket. The US military and SpaceX are currently discussing the possibility of using the Starship to deliver military resources across the world within minutes. We're talking about a point-to-point machine that can travel from London to Hong Kong in 34 minutes, or Tokyo to Singapore in 28 minutes. Musk believes that passengers will most likely need a restraint mechanism like Disney's Space Mountain roller coaster due to the enormous speed that the Starship will offer. And from the flight times that we've quoted so far, we certainly don't doubt him. Like every other rocket designed by SpaceX, the Starship will be reusable. This, combined with its huge size and enormous power, means the cost per trip ratio of the rocket will be ridiculously cheap. According to reports, each orbital trip with the Starship rocket will cost $2 million, as against the $62 million required to execute a single space trip with the Falcon 9. Musk plans to drive down the cost further down to $200,000. Now imagine how cost-effective and efficient the next generation Starship will be. The Starship 2.0 will no doubt extend our capability to journey through the vastness of the universe, from Earth to the Moon, to Mars and back again. This revolutionary spacecraft will change the way we travel.